everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We're on to the divisional round now, two steps away from playing on the biggest stage in sports. It's the Jets going up against the Chiefs. With that, we're off to Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City, where we welcome in our broadcasters, Brandon Gaudu and Charles Davis.
Larry, as always, it is a frenzied atmosphere inside Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. Straight ahead, we punch the second of two tickets to the AFC title game, and we've got a great one in store between the New York Jets and the Kansas City Chiefs. Hello, everyone. As the postseason continues here on EA Sports, we're pleased to bring it to you. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And who has the edge here? You got one side that had some extra rest, but another comes in off a win last week in the wild card round.
And it's funny, depending on which team you are, you say that that's an advantage. You'll take the rest. You'll take the week off, get your guys healed up a little bit and ready to go. But that team that's coming in off of a win last week, they're really excited to keep playing. They feel like they are hot and ready to go.
For a berth in the AFC Championship game, off we go in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. Fielded about a yard deep. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. Leading them out is going to be their quarterback. That's the grizzled vet, Ryan Fitzpatrick.
One thing that I think Ryan Fitzpatrick doesn't get enough credit for is his toughness. This is a guy who plays through injuries, but it's also being mentally tough. Knowing that everyone's always trying to move him out of the lineup, trying to find a replacement for him, yet he continues to battle and has earned the total respect of his teammates.
Now a run. This is Bilal Powell. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackle was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Dumps off to Powell. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 7 yards on the play, and they're going to have a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Fitzpatrick, and he's got a noon one. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first.
It went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. This is the running back, Powell. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46. A look at the starting side for the offense and Brandon Marshall.
I think the thing that impresses me most about Brandon Marshall is his strength. How he runs his routes, how he wins against defensive backs downfield, how it's so tough to keep him from getting the football.
They'll run again. Again, it's Powell. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at 6. And let's take a look at the defensive starters for Kansas City.
Justin Houston is truly one of the elite pass rushers in the league. Knows how to get to the quarterback with a variety of moves.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Defense sinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on 3rd and 6. Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. And that is incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. So here are the Chiefs now coming out for their opening drive. They'll be led out by the number one overall selection back in 05 out of the University of Utah. It's Alex Smith.
I think one of the things that attracted people to Alex Smith initially was his mobility, and that's never changed. That guy's a great athlete, but he's so sharp with the football, so accurate, and takes care of it so well, he rarely puts his team in bad situations.
A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff.
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Now it's the Princeton man. This is Spencer Ware. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. This is the offense we're going to see coming up in this one, and Travis Kelce will be key.
What a tremendous weapon he is, especially in the red zone. Knows how to find the end zone when running his routes.
And the Jets D, they call on a couple extra defensive backs on third. A shotgun snap for Smith. Looking left side, that's caught by Macklin. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's 4th down.
A short game that doesn't get them the first down brings up a 4th down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. So on 4th down, Dustin Colquitt to punt for KC. Back deep for the Jets, Jalen Marshall. He'll send this one into the Midwestern air, and it's a good one. And this will be taken at the 13. Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
And a nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Jets take possession. And now out come the Jets. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out, give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. She took the words right out of my mouth. He was trying for his running back, Bilal Powell, and it's 2nd down.
Partner, was that Justin Houston breaking up a pass on his own drop there?
It was indeed the former Georgia Bulldog.
Yeah, normally what we talk about with him, rushing the passer. That's where he's really earned his reputation. But showing here he can be a complete player with that great speed of his.
And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd. It looked like he might have had a window there, but the rhythm was just a little bit off.
Certainly was, because everything that has to come together to get a pass completed. Yeah, you're right. The sync just wasn't there.
On 3rd down, Fitzpatrick. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side before lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
Just a yard return there after a punt of 49. And it's Chiefs football, 1st and 10. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And the first drive, 3 and out. 2nd possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. Couple of Jets there in on the stop. And a look now at how the Jets line up defensively.
Leonard Williams was one of the top draft picks coming out of USC. And he's done nothing to diminish the comparisons people make of past greats.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. with Ware. And an alley to run. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. It goes as a gain of 8. It moves the chains.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They run it here. Where? And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
They'll run now with Ware. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47. Couple of jets there in on the stop. See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves. But I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Here's Dustin Colquitt now. On for his second punt, he'd take a repeat of his first. This is away and a very good kick, angled for the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds, and they spotted it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. The Chiefs defense, they get set and ready to do battle again. Their stay on the field last time was short-lived with a 3-and-out. See if they can get some more of that.
And ordinarily, you want to be on the field playing, right? But 3-and-out, that's almost gold to a defense. Get to the bench, get some rest, turn the ball over to your offense.
We'll see what they can do here, see if they can force another 3-and-out. They begin with a carry for Powell. And he'll lose yardage on this one back to the 13. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
Quincy Anunua with the intended receiver. And it's third down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. Off the play fake here, Fitzpatrick. Finding time. Great protection. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Here's Lachlan Edwards now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. And And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. He'll take it at the 42. Slips past him.
Where'd he go?
Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away, and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
He's going to loft one deep left side here. And this is caught inside the five. A big play there. Smith to Macklin. 41 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Kansas City. Jeremy Macklin from a yard out. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead. So a tiptoe catch back of the end zone, so tough to do, but he made it look pretty easy.
Certainly did, and the back of the end zone is treated the same way as the sideline. You have to get your feet down in bounds for it to count as a catch. How about the backgrounds of some of these guys, though? Did they work out? Maybe some of them were ballet, some dance, who knows?
Yeah, you and I were talking the other day. I remember one of my favorite kids' shows growing up. I don't know that I want to name it, but guys like Lynn Swan, they used to be on there showing their ballet skill.
And you have to remember when they were kids and their parents would tell them to take the ballet classes, you know they were fighting them like crazy. But right now they're saying, thanks, Mom.
It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. Now, after the touchdown, here's Santos to kick this one away. On the return, it's Jalen Marshall. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Now the Jet offense about to take over as they head out onto the field. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul-searching now?
I would say so, and they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots, but what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
Well, we saw the practice film this week. They wanted to focus on these intermediate passing plays, and it paid off there.
And they took that focus not just to the practice field, but in the film room to show the guys exactly what they wanted, what types of looks they should expect to get, and how they would beat those coverages each and every time, and it paid off on that play. I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
So here we go, first and 10 now. First down throw for Fitzpatrick. And this is caught. First catch by Brandon Marshall. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you go lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen.
And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Quincy Anunua, 26 yards. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. Tyreek Hill on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. come the Chiefs now. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm.
And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Spencer Ware, 70 yards. And the Chiefs have taken the lead. Well called, well blocked, and then he just made a great play. That was an athlete going a long way.
Yeah, how about the suddenness to it? Just getting there and taking off and going. For the defensive guys, plays like that really hurt.
Now the point after try for Santos. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter. So they hit pay dirt on just one play. The long run, the scamper, and a very nice scamper into the end zone for the touchdown. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The New York set to take the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Second down, Fitzpatrick. Quick throw, that's complete on the inside slant. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
First down, Fitzpatrick. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. We have played a quarter here in this AFC Divisional Playoff. 14-7 is the score, and we're back to Arrowhead after this. With Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you, it's the Jets in possession as we begin quarter number two here. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. From the shotgun, it's Fitzpatrick. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Simple slant route, and part of a really nice hard throw by the quarterback.
Nice timing between the quarterback and the receiver. They were perfectly in sync, and he put it right on him on the inside route.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. A big play that time on the catch and run, and the Jets are going to get a new set of downs.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
They run with Powell. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
They go again with Powell. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth, you know, because you always hear about the smaller running back, like, it's lost, you can't find him, and sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive linemen, the defensive line guys trying to find him, trying to peek around people to see him, and he gets lost. And this guy gets lost in a good way for his offense, picking up big yardage.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Only a yard that time, second and goal.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. They'll run. This is Powell. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost four there, and it's third down. So they're back at the seven now for third and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it. Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good, but when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
On second down, here's Smith. To the right side, it's Kelsey. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catchability, rackability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now a first down throw, it's Smith. It's complete to Chris Conley. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Quick pass play there on the slant, Charles. Works out well for the offense.
The offense loves it, the defender hates it. Hard to get through the body of the receiver to get to the football trying to cover a slant.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground.
Hey, hey, hey. We got three.
Here's Smith now on second down. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Macklin. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Hey, hey, tight end to right. Watch tight end.
They'll come out in the pistol. The ground. This is where. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
They've got tight left. Watch tight end. Watch tight end. Key the tight end. Force.
Here's the option going right. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down.
Three out, three out.
From the red zone now, Smith. Can't find anyone open. It's brought in by Harris. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. A shotgun snap for Smith. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. This will be the eighth play of the drive. It's third and seven.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air.
And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Santos now to add the PAT. It's good, and it's 21-10. Now, after the touchdown, here's Santos to kick this one away. This is taken at the three. Oh, nice move. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Jets' offensive unit ready to get going here. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Fitzpatrick now to throw on first down. That one complete to Anderson. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine. So what will they do? On the ground, through the air? Let's see. Second and nine. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
On third down, Fitzpatrick. He's got time in the pocket. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Justin Houston in there to drop him, and his great season continues. 13 sacks for him now on the year. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Here's Lachlan Edwards now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. The Jets defense, we watch them get set to go now. Last drive, touchdown surrendered. Here, see if they can stop him.
It's always a constant battle of letting the last series go, good or bad. but especially bad. Give up a touchdown. Okay, forget the finger pointing, forget the blame. Go back out and play the defense you know you're capable of and help your team out.
And probably look to the leaders, as always.
As always. They're going to be the ones going to grab some people and say, all right, let's do this thing. Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
One receiver left, three to the right. On second and 10, Smith. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Out of the gun, Smith. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Fielded at the 33. That'll go as a 39-yard punt. Give him 9 on the return. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to keep that little quarterback strut going right now to make sure that his team sees him as confident. Continue to try and up his game, but just let them know, hey, if I'm around, if I'm the one calling signals and throwing the football, just follow me, we'll get there. Sometimes that will do more to elevate a team than anything else.
See if he has that confidence. It's a 5-receiver set, 3 to the left, 2 to the right. Second down, Fitzpatrick. And Anderson's got it. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Well, so much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice gain. The defense had felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him.
And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Second down, looking to throw, Fitzpatrick. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. 12 yards there as they move the chains. Time to step aside. Back with more AFC playoff action after this timeout. A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Larry Ridley at halftime. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play. A first down throw for Fitzpatrick. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Marshall, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. Throwing again here, Fitzpatrick on second and 10. And he comes back with one complete. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. Simple slant route, and it works to perfection.
And when you're a big-bodied receiver, you use it like it's a basketball play. Body the defender away and catch the football.
Dumps off to Powell. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It'll be a three-yard gain, and that'll make this a second down. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So
now Fitzpatrick hit. It's out. He lost the football. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
Thank goodness for heaters up here. And thank goodness I don't have to carry the football in this game. It's January. It's cold out there. Trying to clutch the football and absorb the hits, not easily done.
Yeah, we saw a product of the elements right there. Smith and company heading back out there now. And he's been good. Two first half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence, does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling them on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Five wides in the game, four of them to the right side. Now a first down throw, it's Smith. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Three receivers to the left, one to the right. Back to the air, Smith on second down. They're complete. This is Albert Wilson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Fresh set of downs here. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On first down, it's Smith. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Smith now to throw. He's got a man wide open. It's Macklin. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
On first and 10, Smith. He's got time. And on the left side here, Wilson. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. From the left hash, it's a 42-yard attempt. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good, and that will get the lead up to 14. So it's a seven-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front seven. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
And after the made field goal, Santos back out there to kick it away. Set to return, here's Nick Marshall. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So it's on to halftime of this AFC Divisional Round matchup, as we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Chiefs have done a good job today stepping up, and they lead after two. The Jets really looked great last week, but it hasn't been so easy for them in this one. All right, let's do this. Here's the first half highlights. Chiefs lined up at the 43. Tight coverage here, but the completion is made, and the pass and catch will end up going for 41 yards. Chiefs now later on the drive. Smith's on point with the throw, and he finds his mark for the score. He'll take the early advantage. Jets line up at the 26. Quick pass is complete, and he'll take this all the way for the touchdown. The Jets tied up at 7. Now first and 10, Ware's going to stay inside after the handoff, and he'll take this all the way for a touchdown. The Chiefs up now by 7. Chiefs ball early in the second. Kelsey's found on the quick pass, and it's going to end up going for a gain of 32. Same drive, Smith's on target here, and he kept off the 9-play drive with a TD. Chiefs push their lead to 11. Jets is on 2nd and 7. We're going to get a fumble here. So that's all for us here at the EA Sports Studio. We'll get you back out to the field now for some more playoff action.
This one taken from the 7. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number 3. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed, and that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage. Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
Throwing on 3rd down, Smith. It's Hill, complete. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's 4th down. Here's Dustin Colquitt now as he's on to punt for Kansas City.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. Here's the Jets offense now getting set to start off this 3rd quarter. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter 3.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. 2nd down now after the pass completion. Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. And he's going to be taken down. Sacked back at the 2. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack. And it'll lead to a 3rd and long.
Well, if an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite part. Gets a chance to get after the quarterback. It's almost like a reverse red zone. they can create points using their defense. And this time they take their man down.
And an extra DB here for the Chiefs on third down.
Pass situation.
And a give this time to the tailback. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth.
One of the things I love about this game is there's a match of wits throughout the game. Who's going to get the advantage? Who's going to catch someone off guard? I feel like the offense thought they might catch the defense off balance with that play call. But unfortunately, that didn't work for them.
And he's able to get it out of there. Wow, evasive.
Make a miss.
Call that a 44-yard punt, 5 on the return. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a 1st and 10 on the short side of the field. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on the other side of the ball. They went into halftime, made a few adjustments. And you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in their ability to play. Because a lot of times you get beat down in the first half, it gets ugly in the second half. They've come out with a new resolve and a renewed determination.
Watch tight, watch tight. Tight end right, tight end right.
Hey, move, over, over.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. 9 yards on the pickup there as he'll be left with 3rd and 1. And 3rd quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding the clock.
Smith going to throw on 3rd and 1. Able to find Harris. Complete. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic. So anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add a little extra at the end with a short run.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Just 1 yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
To throw is Smith, surveying the field. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. From the red zone now, Smith. And this is caught, Jeremy Maclin. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Here's Smith now on 2nd down. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, what credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good, and that'll push the lead up to 17. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs went to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
After the made field goal, Santos back out there to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position.